It's a very interesting time to have you. You both worked in the Obama White House, senior advisor. You were chief speechwriter. And you actually interviewed, you got the last interview with President Barack Obama in office.
Managed to snag that,
You got him to do your podcast, which is a huge get.
That's a huge get.
For him, the fact that he got to do a podcast, he must be like,
lucky guy.
He was very excited.
And obviously, tomorrow, Donald Trump being sworn in, being in the White House in the final days, how are you processing? How does this feel right now?
It feels great. Wonderful. No, it's bizarre. I mean, we were there yesterday, and, you know, there's moving trucks and boxes, and everyone's leaving their offices, and it's weird to think that, you know, just 8 years ago, we were walking in there on our first day.
And so talk about what a first day is like in the White House, because it really is, like, the starting gun goes off, and you're the president.
Yeah.
Yeah, you sit there in the cold, you watch your boss give this speech, become president of the United States, they put you on a bus, they drive you to the White House, they drop you off, the building's empty, they show you to a door that has your name on it. You go inside, there's a post-it note with the password for your computer, and you're in charge of the country.
Yeah, go. Like, that's how go around the country.
Yeah.
And then are there, do your predecessors leave notes? Is there any sense of this is, or is that all handled in the transition?
Really? My predecessor left me some cigars in the drawer. That's all I
have. That's
about
it. And obviously, we talked about it earlier in the show, President-elect Trump says he's going to get sworn in tomorrow, Friday, and he's considering his first day Monday. That is not, that is unconventional, yes?
Yeah, that doesn't usually happen. You don't get weekends off in the White House.
What is the difference between a weekend and a weekday at the White House?
You can not wear suits on the weekend.
Although we wore a suit on the first weekend.
Right.
And the president called us in and said, in my White House, you can wear jeans on Saturdays and Sundays.
Well, there you go. It was a laid-back White House.
Yeah.
And then working with President Obama, and I assume just in any sort of advisory role or speech writing role, it must be strange to be in a position to give criticism or to be, I'd say, feel as though in order to do your job, you have to give criticism to the most powerful man in the world. Was that something you learned to do? How did you find your way to that?
I remember the first day I ever wrote for him when he was still senator, and he edited a speech. He came over to my desk and he goes, so I made a bunch of edits in this speech and I just want to make sure you're okay with these edits. And I'm like, you're Barack Obama. Yeah, I'm okay with the edits. So he's very good about it. Like, he always wants to hear opposing viewpoints. Yeah. He was very good.
Are there people that are too afraid to give opposing viewpoints? And then does that make them bad at their job?
Well, it's hard at first. Like, even if as smart as you are, as tough as you are, you go in the Oval Office and the pageantry of it, it's what you see on TV or in the West Wing or whatever. But he demands that of you, and he sort of tests people early on. He often likes to argue the opposite point he believes to sort of test the parameters of the argument, and he'll call on the new person to see what they'll say about it. And those who will push back, he sort of makes a mental note that this might be someone who's going to be very useful to me. And if they're just kind of like, yes, sir, that makes great sense. You know, he has a different opinion.
Right, like if he says, I think Beyonce is overrated and people agree with him, they're like, get rid of him.
That's right.
I gave him a layup and they blew it. Get him out of here.